Hello students, welcome to the video on subprograms. So what is the subprograms? Subprograms are named PLSQL blocks. So in PLSQL we'll be using the subprograms, and inside those blocks we'll be writing some statements or some code which will be reused again and again several times. Whenever we call or whenever we invoke them, the subprograms will be executed automatically. So these subprograms are nothing but like our user defined functions which we have used in our C and C++. But compared to that, here we have major differences. So here we have subprograms are of two types. Number one is stored procedure, number two is functions. So about this only we are going to learn in this video. So first to start with stored procedures. So in stored procedure is a named block. So what is this stored procedure? So till now we have created several programs in our previous videos. So every single program contains a procedure, that's what we have seen. So all those are stored procedures. So every stored procedure will have a name, and inside that we'll be writing some codings which will perform a particular task. And these procedures mainly provide modularity. Modularity in the sense I can divide the whole set of program into a set of procedures, so that it will be very convenient for me to call them whenever I want, and I can also reuse them. If I write them once, I can reuse them several times. Again and again, I need not write those set of statements. If I write once in a procedure, I can call it any number of times. So that is also one of the main advantage of stored procedure. And the third one is a procedure will not return any values through parameters. So like our void in our C language, so we have procedures over here, so it will not return any value through the parameters. So that we have to understand it very clearly. So the stored procedures use the following parameter modes. So in stored procedures, we have some parameter modes which we have to use in order to pass the values to the procedures. Number one is in. The in mode is default. Even when you don't give any parameters or any modes, by default your MySQL, your PLSQL will determine it as in mode only. So till now we didn't give any parameters or any modes, so it is understood as by default it takes the parameter mode in. Next, it indicates the parameters can be passed into the stored program, but that any modifications made are not returned to the calling program. In short, if I want to tell about this, we have learned about call by value in our previous years in C and C++. Call by value means whatever changes that are made to the formal parameters, the actual parameters will not get affected. The same manner here also, we are going to use the mode in. So whatever changes you are making in the called program, whatever changes you are making in the called procedure, it will not affect the calling procedure, the parameters present in the calling procedure. So when I show you a practical example, you'll automatically understand it. So the next one is out, which is just opposite to in. So this mode means that we can assign the value to the parameter, but that value will change in the actual parameter also, in the calling program also. So whatever changes you make to the formal parameter, the actual parameter will also get affected. But if you want to combine both these things in a single parameter, then you have to use in out. So whatever we have done in and out as a separate. So these three modes combined together. In means only the input parameter, out means only the output parameter. You know, if I want both input as well as output in the same parameter, then you have to use the mode as in out together without any space. So if I want to explain this in a better manner, I have to write a program. So we'll just get back to our command line client. Hello, welcome to the video. So now I'm going to select a database. Use test. So I've selected my database. Now I want to create a procedure. So create procedure, and this time I'm going to give it as some fun one, some name. So here I'm going to pass first only the in parameter, in x of integer type. Now I'm going to pass only the in parameter first. Again, I'm giving the begin. After begin, I'm just declaring. So I'll do one thing. Instead of declaring, I'll use set x equal to x plus 1. So directly, since I declared already in my parameter, I need not declare it inside. So directly, I can get the value of x and increment the value of x. Yeah, sorry, by mistake I made the error of not giving the delimiter. So I'll provide the delimiter and then I'll create a procedure. Begin, set, now, end, delimiter. Now my procedure is created. Now I'm passing the value set at the rate of x equal to 300. Now I'm passing the value of x as 300, and notice one point very clearly here: at the rate of x acts like a actual parameter, and here x acts like a formal parameter. Now at the rate of x value is set to 300. Now I'm going to call my function, sorry, procedure at the rate of x double dollar. Now I'm passing the actual parameter here, that is 300, that will go automatically here and replace in x, and then my x value is incremented to 301. Now I made some changes in the called program. I didn't make changes in the calling program. I made the changes in the called program. So as soon as I press enter, my query is okay. Now if I want to display the output, select at the rate of x double dollar sign. Now if you see this, when I press enter, I'll get the output of at the rate of x as 300 only. I'll not get 301. You can ask me a question like, I have passed the 300 value here, automatically it comes to x. Now 300 plus 1 is 301. And remember one thing very clearly, the in parameter mode works like a call by value. Whatever changes that are made in the called function or called procedure will not affect the calling procedure. So that's what we have to understand it very clearly. So this is known as called program, this is known as calling program, as mentioned in the slides. So whatever changes that are made to the called program will affect the calling program. So when I press enter now, my x value will be 300 only, it will not be 301, since my parameter mode is in. The same thing if I create a procedure fun2, this time I'm going to create a two parameters. One is for int comma out answer int. So I'm creating two parameters here. One is for input, one is for output. So n is for in and ins is for out. Now again begin. Set ans equals to n plus 10 and double dollar sign. Now my query is okay. Now I'm going to call this function fun2. Now here I'm going to pass the value as 10 comma at the rate of ans. Again I'm providing $2 sign. As soon as when I press enter, now if you see here, call fun2, I'm calling the fun2 and procedure name fun2, and then I'm passing the values 10 and at the rate of ans. Now here notice one point very clearly, 10 I'm passing, so automatically it goes and stores in the variable n, and at the rate of ans will go and store in the variable ans. Why I'm doing like this? Now as soon as when I call select at the rate of ans, so what output will be present here? So when I pass the value 10, it goes and stores in the variable n, and when I pass the value at the rate of ans, it goes and stores in the variable ans. Now n plus 10, so n value is how much? 10. 10 plus 10 is 20. Now 20 will go and store in the which variable? Ans. Now but ans contains the address of at the rate of ans, so some changes are made to the called program over here. So formal parameter, so here ans is a formal parameter, at the rate of ans is the actual parameter. So some changes are made to the formal parameter. Since this is the out mode, so whatever changes are done inside the program will be shown or will be passed to the parameter which is present outside. So I have my changes for ans here, it has mentioned it as 10 plus 10 is 20, so my ans value is 20, and since I mentioned it as out mode, now from inside the procedure the value will move on to the outside the procedure. Outside the procedure I have the variable as at the rate of ans. So in at the rate of ans, if I press enter, I'll get the value as 20. So this is how it works. So if you can see here, in is separate, out is separate. In, whatever changes that you make to the called program will not affect the calling program. But in out mode, whatever changes you are making to the called program, it will automatically affect the calling program. That's what we have to understand over here. Now I want to just combine and do in one single variable. So again, I'm creating a procedure. Fun3. In out, in int. Now if you notice here, in out together I gave us one variable. Earlier I gave two variables, for in separate variable, out separate variable. Now for in and out combined together, there is only one variable. Now if I begin this, begin set n equal to n plus 10 and double dollar sign. Now my query is okay. I want to set the value of at the rate of n. So this is the actual parameter which I'm going to pass, equals 10. I'm pressing enter and then call the procedure function fun3, and inside this I'm going to pass the actual parameter, that is at the rate of n. Now if your at the rate of n value is 10, and after it goes here, it replaces the formal parameter n over here. N plus n is 20, that is 10 plus 10 is 20, and the value of n becomes 20. Since this is the out, same n variable is for out also. Now that n will be written from the called program to the calling program and replacing the variable at the rate of n. Now when I select at the rate of n, double dollar sign, and I press enter, I'll get the value as 20. So you have to understand one thing very clearly here. In or out, that doesn't matter. If you provide in separately, out separately, they act as an in parameter and out parameter. Now if you go both together, if you give the same variable access in as well as out parameter together. That's what we have to understand in this program. I hope so you understood this. Now we'll get back to the slides. Next we'll see about the concept of functions. So what is a function? Functions are just similar to a procedure. Then what is the difference between them? The difference between them is that a function will always return a value, whereas a procedures will never return a value. So this is what we have to understand. Functions will return a value, whereas procedures will not return any value. And the syntax of creating a function is create function functioning within the parentheses. You have to provide the parameters, and you have to provide the returns data type, and at the end you have to provide the return. So we have two things over here, returns as well as return, that you'll understand when we are seeing in the program. And in order to delete a procedure or drop a procedure, we have to use the syntax drop procedure procedure name, and similarly for the function, drop function function name. So in this video we have to understand only one thing: functions will return a value, whereas in our previous concept, procedures will not return any value. So in order to illustrate this, we'll see a small program. So in this video we are going to see about creation of function. So I already selected my database. Now I'm going to create a function. So before creating function, we have to provide delimiter and double dollar sign. And now I'm going to create my function, create function. Imagine my function name is myfun, and inside this I'm going to give only one parameter, which is of integer type. And notice one point, I'm not passing any in mode or out mode, because by default functions will return a value. And after that I'm providing returns, and which data type it returns? This function, it returns integer data type. And after that I'm providing the begin. Inside begin I'm giving a declare statement, declare x as integer type. And after that I'm going to set the value of x equal to n into n. So I'm just multiply n 2 times n square times, and then I'm going to return the value of x. So return x, and then I'm going to end this. So after that I just press enter. Now if you see, my query is okay. Now in this program, just I did only square of the values. Now I'm just directly passing, and remember one more thing: in our procedure we use call keyword, but in functions we need not use call keyword. Directly you can use select myfun. Within the parenthesis, you can pass the value, that is 10. You can pass any value, whatever you want. and then I'm giving double dollar sign. Now if you see here, my FUN value, I'm passing the value as 10. Now automatically after function calling, it goes to the function definition. Now n value is 10 over here. And inside the function, I'm declaring a value variable x, output variable x. Now n into n, that is 10 into 10 is 100. I'm returning that value x. When I say return x, it combines with returns also. So this function returns which data type? Integer data type. And this variable is also of integer data type. If both are matching only, the value will be returned from the function, called function to the calling function. So automatically this x will come, and this function was called by this particular myFUN10. So here the value will come and replace. Now when I press enter, you can see myFUN of 10, answer I got as 100. And we have to understand only one thing, I didn't use any out parameter or in parameter like in our previous slides. So we directly use the function. Function has a capacity to automatically return the value to the calling function. I hope so you understood this. And I hope so you understood this. Now we'll get back to the slides. So we came to the end of the video. In the next video, we'll be seeing about cursors. I hope so in this video, you have understood about the subprograms, that is the stored procedures and functions. So I'll meet you in the next video. Thank you.